Italy's Amalfi Coast is all about spectacular scenery and a bounty of incredible food. I'm Carol Yelverton. Welcome to Hungry for Travel TV. We're making my family recipe for linguine and clam sauce and a perfect salad for the side. The Amalfi Coast, just south of Naples, has so much charm that you can really get swept away in its beauty. What a pretty short film by Philip Huser. I am so in love with Southern Italian cooking. It's fresh and light with beautiful pizzas, pastas, risottos, and an abundance of fish and seafood. My Italian-American grandmother was a powerful force, and we grew up cooking and eating just the best homemade Italian dishes. My mother made this one her own. It's called linguine con la vongole, linguine and clam sauce. So I've made a few adaptations of my own because I know she wouldn't mind. So I'm going to run you through this really fast, but I have 4 shallots and 4 cloves of garlic that I have sauteed together in a very good quality Italian olive oil. And then what I'm going to do is add a good amount of Italian parsley. I've got a little bit of red pepper. You don't need that much of it. I'm going to put in just a touch of sea salt. We've got some more salty stuff coming later. I've got some black pepper, some oregano, and it's about a teaspoon of oregano. It can use a good amount of it. Fresh thyme, which makes a huge difference, much better than the dried stuff. And I'm putting a bay leaf in because that adds just a really lovely flavor. Again, just take it out when you're done. And anchovies, those tiny little fish, are everywhere along the Amalfi Coast. They're so salty and sharp. A little bit goes a long way. And what I'm doing now is just using some anchovy paste. That's gonna go in, and what that does is it just pops out the sweetness in the clams. It's really, really good. So I'm also going to put in some clam broth. And the idea behind this is we're not cooking the clams quite yet. What we want to do is just get a good broth because we're going to be baking the pasta together. So now this will be all cooked up. I have got pasta that is half cooked and drained. So it's cooked about 6 or 7 minutes. And this goes in. And the idea here is, again, that it's going to bake together. Now, we all love fresh pasta, but it's really not the way to go here. Dry pasta makes a big difference because it's going to be absorbing a ton of the sauce here. Italian pasta is made with semolina flour, so it really makes a difference in how your food is going to taste. We buy Italian olive oil for its flavor. It's really the same kind of thing here. Okay, so the pasta and sauce are going to go for about 450 for 10 minutes, and I wrap this really tight in foil. I really remember my mother doing that. It has to be tight in foil so it forms a nice steam bath. So that's going to cook 10 minutes in total. But now let's get to the clams. I have soaked 2 pounds of small clams in sea salt. You can use little necks or vanilla clams for about a half hour. Then I rinse them. That washes the sand out of them. Now they're ready for action. So what I do, I just take them, I put them in here with just a little bit of water, and then I'm just going to cover them, and I'm going to let them go for 5 minutes only, until they are just done, just tender, not overcooked, just juicy, and really all ready for the pasta. So I'm going to show you quickly how this comes together. I take the clams out, I put that clam broth in, and I also add a little Parmesan cheese, and I've got some more parsley here, and then the juice of a lemon goes in. And the fresh lemon juice on tops, boy, that really, really makes a difference. So let me show you the finished shot right now, because I really love this picture too. I had so much fun taking this. I've nestled the clams into the pasta. I've topped them with a little lemon zest. So now the salty, garlicky sauce is embedded into the pasta, and these sweet, tender little clams just taste so good. There's that touch of red pepper, those anchovies, and the lemon infusion. This is really the taste of Amalfi's small villages and towns. They have lemons growing everywhere there. You know, you're going to find a lot to do when you go to the Amalfi Coast too. I mean, just cruising along that coastline is unbelievable, as this Bus to Alps tour found out. With so many fruits and vegetables growing along the Amalfi coastline, I've got a salad that I think goes beautifully with our pasta. You know, it's all about seeing what's fresh and using it in lovely and delicious ways. So I've pre-sliced radicchio lengthwise. It has a very strong character to it, but it's not bitter. It's just a really interesting taste and flavor. Very, very Italian. And now I'm just putting some beautiful spinach on the sides. So this really is kind of a composed salad. Nice fresh baby spinach leaves that go on the side. This is super simple, but this is how it works there. And then some beautiful asparagus. It's going to go right in the middle. So there, it's that simple a salad. It's that beautiful. Now, I want to tell you that for your vinaigrette, you are going to use something that is really going to be simple. Really going to work. We want to dress it. We don't want to overpower this kind of a salad with too heavy a dressing. It's all about balance with the big flavors of the radicchio and the asparagus. So I want to show you something special. My Italian grandmother, I told you about her. This is her salad dressing cruet. And this actually has her maiden initials on it, Camille Lucia, from before she was married. She was married in 1923. So this is really a family heirloom. And she always had her own vinaigrette that she would make and that she kept in the cupboard. So again, I've got my own, but I appreciate hers. And all I do for this is I use a cup of olive oil to a third cup of white balsamic. And I'm not going to overwhelm this. This is really just about a little drizzle on top. So that's all that's going to happen here. So let me show you the finished product, because it's going to be all dressed up and looking divine. Three vegetables with distinct tastes. They just merge together here in all the right ways. It's such a bright contrast to the soft, chewy textures of the pasta and clams. And that was a fun picture to take. I had a lot of fun with the pictures this show. Okay, time to take in more of the gorgeous look and feel of the Amalfi Coast. The young voyagers shot some very cool footage to give you a view from above.
Sueño cuando era pequeño, sin preocupación en el corazón. Sigo viendo aquel momento, se desvaneció, desapareció. Ya no te creo, ya no te deseo, eo. Solo te veo, solo te deseo, eo. Mira, Sofía, sin tu mirada sigo, sin tu mirada sigo. Dime, Sofía, ¿cómo te mira? Dime, ¿cómo te mira? Dime, sé que no, sé que no.
So pretty. And then there are desserts. You'll find amazing pastries everywhere you look, as well as locally grown foods that grace dinner tables with nuts and little clementines and grapes, some cookies and dried fruits. This is what is just very much part of the life there. Everyone is around the table, eating, talking, just being together. It's all about family and community and a sense of place. So go. Eat and enjoy, as any Italian mama would tell you. I'm Carol Yelverton. Until I see you next time, stay hungry for travel.